So we did the intake timing already. Now we're going to do the exhaust cam timing.
Five,
so the exhaust cam is almost where it belongs, but the intake was out of whack. 116 is what we were looking for, and it's at 117.5. All right, so what we came up with on our intake, exactly what we thought, 119.75. That's not what we thought, but we knew it was not in the right spot, because last time we had the car out, we couldn't get it to rev up and get boost on the trans brake. It was kind of flat. This number, according to comp cams, they wanted it 107 to start with, or even maybe lower. And they were saying 116 on the exhaust. So now we know where it's at. Now we know when we put it back together what we need to do. There's a shot of the intake. Side of the head. If you look here, cylinder 4, cylinder 6 on the leak down showed heavy intake leakage. You can see it had exhaust coming back through. So the exhaust side.
One more.
Get the little washer out.
Do these come off?
Yeah.
It looks like you're going into the block here.
Yeah.
Driver's side. it's still right there. There's a green one back there under the... No, you're fine. Luckily, we're not recording live now, so I can cut out whatever I need to cut out. All right. That's one piece to get off. How was it?
A little hot rod. Dedicated. I think it has a lot of, all said, I'd rather look at it than drive it. But it has a lot of cool things going on. Are you on camera or something?
I'm taping, the edit there. We were live, but...
Oh, you don't want me in it.
Well, I'm filming this so I can edit when I'm done.
This is Leo's wife.
Yes, it is.
Oh, they came over, huh?
Yes.
Oh, okay. How you doing?
No, just the dog and I came to Super Bowl.
Well, I didn't see him at the time. I thought, who's Kelly? Now I remember from the tuning shop that one time we talked.
Thank you.
We talked about my little Vega and bringing it over to the racetrack and stuff. That was a long time ago now.
Yeah.
Years ago.
Okay.
Thank you for remembering.
They're taking long. He's already in there,
yeah,
huh?
He's still in there.
We stripped.
Okay.
You're so tiny.
In fact, I wonder...
Should be my pocket,
left pretty straight, and I'd want that thing almost touching, so we keep the plate on. Oh, okay. I got you. Sandwiching situation.
As opposed to
In today's world, I don't think there is any
difference.
I don't know where the plumbing is. That's how that
is. Is that this one here?
You got to go to the DNA, say. Born this way.
That actually goes into the block.
Stuff makes sense.
Right. That goes right here.
So we should put a bolt in there.
Yeah, why not? That's got a time cert in it. Well, that's what he's done. He's time certed them all to make them American thread.
Yeah. Okay, so we just need to
open the silicone out and put a bolt back in it.
You saw my truck.
Yep.
Yesterday, George came over with that big white truck.
Oh, yeah.
He's got a lot more experience driving it than I do. Today was basically my first try. I did hit one curb.
That's okay. Curbs are okay.
He backed that sucker with the trailer on it.
He does it barefoot watching YouTube.
Into our driveway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing.
It's got a narrow gate on it. I couldn't believe when I walked out
and
it was there.
Yeah, that driveway is...
To talk to his insurance agent. I think there's probably some untold stories in there.
Between the narrow gate and the narrow culvert.
Yeah. Well, Leo used to... Did you ever see the brown truck that we had before?
No, I only saw the red one.
We had one prior to that. little smaller, about the same size. He used to back it up, our driveway in town with a stone wall, granite stone wall on one side, and a concrete curb on the other.
Go in here for the time being? Yeah, I'll go in there for now. Just so it's not sitting on...
Right.
So you're busy here until...
So here's what we use for the rocker arms. They're gessel rockers with a solid gessel tappet that comes apart and it has shims, and you adjust it with these shims. Put a stack of shims on there, put the tappet back together, and then recheck your valve lash. That's how that's done on this engine.
Amazing what happened. And I'm finishing up the school jobs we have down here, whatever other jobs. So he doesn't really know how to run the GPS and the instrument like I do, you know what I mean? Because he's more of a cad in the office, but now he has to go out in the field, so. Going through all these headaches trying to get it going here. I'm trying to tell them over the phone what to do.
Chuck, you might want to stand on the back of that engine while he's twisting on there. So there's the cylinder head. As you can tell, as you can see, the number two intake valve is stuck in the seat, in the guide. So there's our leak in the cylinder. You can see the light coming through. The seat didn't drop. Looks like the valve stuck in the guide. Here's the cylinder head. Titanium retainers. We don't know what springs they are yet. We'll go ahead and tear this down and see what that is.
There's the intake ports.
Combustion chambers. Got a little bit of rust on a couple of valves. We're going to have to address that. Come up with some kind of fogging or something while the car is in rest. The head gasket that was in the engine is a Clark 062 copper. It's hard to tell, but you can see it did have the top fuel hoops put in. with the receivers and the cylinder head, so you get really good gasket sealing with that type of a deal. So it's all cleaned up. We can go ahead and reuse this when we're ready to put the engine back together.
So you think these are oversized valves? So the intake is inch 530. Exhaust is inch 250.
Oil pan, which is actually a Trailblazer oil pan, just heavily modified. You can see it's got plated, little even sump in the back, all the connections for the dry sump. Just so you guys can see what was done in there.
The self girdle between the block and the oil pan.
That is true.
Half-inch socket, a black one somewhere. It's not in the rack, so I don't know if we have it out or
12.5 inch.
Yeah, half inch. That's what these are. Yeah. I mean, we move it. So I guess. That made it a little quicker. Yeah, they weren't super tight though. I did it with a wrench, although this wrench is kind of long. You can get pretty good leverage with it. But they got a concave on one side, they square. Yeah. For sure. Chuck, would Dave's scanner scan that?
Sure it would.
All right, we'll do that.
You can ask him, but I'm sure he'll say, oh yeah.
He tells me he can scan anything. Yeah. There's a close-up of the massive block girdle, stud girdle, main girdle, whatever you want to call it, but very nicely designed. All the reliefs for the drain backs, attaches to every main cap and goes between the oil pan and the cylinder block.
So there it is without the self girdle mount on it. Now we'll get the pistons out.
Get it all together. See, that's tight. That's probably 65.
Bearing looks perfect. And they have it marked. I guess that's another one. It's not number 7, so.
Never had an engagement, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah. Yep.
Kind of loose.
We right, want longevity.
We're running out of boxes, aren't we, Chuck? You know what? That muriatic acid box, we're going to take those two jugs out of it.
I'll talk to
him. 2 for 1 on this one. Gun over the plastic on it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sitting there leaning on it trying to.
Yeah.
stage the car to be no oil pressure in the motor. We're trashing that one too. Nothing impregnated the bearing, just a little dirt grease. Definitely gonna rectify that rust. Skim a little bit on the side there. Rod too.
Still warms in there.
Oh, you know what? The bevel looks like it's hanging out of the. Want to look at that compared to the other ones. Hang on, buddy.
Do you want to go out? You just slide him out, right?
Yep. That's funny. This one's the same kind of thing. Bearing's actually inside there, and it hangs over a little bit on that side, on the radius. Almost like the bearings need to be radius more on the opposite side.
That's strange.
Because it's on a single, the bearing looks like for a standard two side-by-side rod, but we have a radius on both sides, so the radius, it's a little tight on the radius, that's what's doing that.
That's probably using like the eighth or
right.
Two-inch.
Yeah. I'll do some research and see what we can find on that. We need a little narrower bearing. I don't want to ride on the radius. I mean, it doesn't seem like it hurt anything, but it only has three passes on it, too.
Right. We definitely don't want to be back here in 6 months taking it back to burn.
No, no.
They're definitely not one bad. No, because I'm hitting on it so hard, eventually the bearing comes out. So that's the way it's sitting on the outfit. So we put in the other one. What?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
I can't put it down.
No, it's
gonna say, there's no dollars now.
Yeah, but no, you put it on the bottom. So the rod is correct. The rod has a radius on both sides, just the bearing doesn't. Bishop, come on, buddy. Come on. Come on, bud.
Hello, baby.
What's that? No, what did you do? That's a problem we gotta cure. Can't have this anymore. A lot of silicone on there. Okay, now we can turn over something left in the block. Oh, yeah, that's rock that stuff. Nothing in the block, it's just everything on the block.
Somebody's gonna get jealous. He's sitting here so sweet and pretty.
Yeah, he's I'm ready for now. Yes, back in March. Thick that bearing in there. That's a stout bearing there.
I think they're the size of a big watch.
I remember reading something about them. And those are nice and pretty. So I can get a head on here, just keep going. I got dowels in there, so I'm just gonna pop them off the dowels.
Here's one thing we didn't want to see. That's the thrust. And it is really bad. This engine only has three passes on it. So we have to really pay attention to what the thrust is in the motor and send the converter out and have the converter check to make sure it's not ballooning, because something caused this. Of course, it didn't help that we couldn't get the car to come up on boost, so it was on the brake for quite a bit. These are the things we're gonna straighten out. Here's the pistons, coated, gas ported, a little smaller diameter ring than I'd like to see. BME, Bill Mitchell aluminum connecting rod. One thing I didn't like when I took it apart is we have a nice bearing clearance on the radius there. On this side, the bearing actually sticks out past the radius a little bit, and you can see there's a scuffing already going on there. So we're gonna have to look for a narrowed bearing in this size to correct that issue. That's putting metal in the oil, which then gets into the bearings and just creates a snowballing effect. So something we're going to work on.
So here's the crankshaft. You can see a lot of knife edging work done to it. By the color, I would say it's probably been nitrided, and the rod journals are cut down to 2-inch. Okay, thank you for watching. Sorry we had so much equipment failure, we couldn't do this all live. But if you have questions on what we did or parts that you're seeing, please leave comments. And as soon as we get some of these parts gone through, we're going to go ahead and reassemble and try to do that live, or at least get some good video on it. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, share, leave comments, bang the bell so you can get notifications whenever we're going to do this. And obviously, as soon as the car is back on the track, we're definitely going to show you some video on that. So, thanks a lot.